welcome John Bon Jovi. Welcome to London. You've been here for a while. A
couple of days.
And I thought about you because you are born and bred in New Jersey. Yeah. And you have your house there. It's a waterfront house. And I wonder how are things? I mean,
it's bad.
Did you speak to your family?
Yeah, my family are safe. They've been moved to a hotel. So they're safe. They're in a place that's got food and power. But all of our houses have, there's no power, there's no water. The devastation is off the charts bad. The president is in my hometown now, in New Jersey. It's like Armageddon. It's like nothing we've ever seen. It's 9/11 and Katrina rolled into one. And so I'm heading home first thing in the morning, as soon as I can land. The airports have been underwater. It's been bad.
And this is not only your home. It's where you come from. It's your.
These are my people. Yeah, this is my people. Yeah, it's my neighbors. It's the neighborhoods that I know. It's where my children surf. 80 houses burned down. Where my keyboard player has his beach house. The houses are on fire. My hometown. The president would not go to my hometown. It's not a, it's not a big place, and it's not even on the ocean, and he's there because of the devastation. It's bad.
Yeah. What can he do?
I got to get there and find out. You know, we take care of each other. People will gather around, that's what happens in these times. People come together.
And this is not only your home. It's also your studio, and it's your office where you run the Bon Jovi company, or what we call it. Tell me, what kind of boss are you?
A boss? Oh, Christ. more of a benevolent dictator is. I'll welcome your opinions and then reject them in time. But I'm pretty welcoming. I certainly share everything with everybody and thoughts with everybody, and it really is a team.
But is your leadership style, is it democratic, or is it?
Everybody participates. Everybody is an integral part of the team. And then.
But they know who they work for.
What about presents? Do they get presents?
Big presents.
Great.
Yeah, they do okay at Christmas.
Great. I'd like to work for you.
Presents.
But do you think this is the way to make a band work over time?
I got thrown out of one. I'm not exactly in one again now. I wouldn't know.
He's done very well. He's done very well. Robbie, I love this guy's music for a lot of years. He's an incredibly talented guy. There's nothing to be fearful of. He's one of the great entertainers, period.
Oh, wow.
In the last 20, 30 years. I've seen him live. I love his records. I love what he does visually. The video stuff, the reunions would take that, we're all cool, but his solo career is outstanding. This guy's
wow.
A major talent.
Thank you. And me back to you. God bless you. Thank you very much.
One of the reasons I think you are that, Rob, that you are such a great showman, is because you do doubt yourself, however. That's the curse.
Do you? No, you don't. I know. Yeah.
Damn you to hell.
Yeah. Which is a brilliant
but
place
I have
to
the
be.
Guys, you see, it's the gang, and that gang, you were in a band, so you know what that is. No, we never lacked self-confidence.
When you did your solo stuff, or when you do your solo stuff,
yeah.
Is it different? Is
sure.
Do you question your ability in any way? Or?
None of it is based on success or failure. That's the artistic expression, and the only thing I ask the Lord for is the opportunity to do it again. I don't care what happens with the rest of it, because I put my best effort to get it to that place. Whatever happens, one thing I'll never have been was a coulda, shoulda, woulda kind of guy. Anything I wanted to do, fail or succeed at it, I did. If it didn't work, oh well.
How much do you think that's got to do with where you come from? Because it's a very gritty, go and do it kind of place, industrial. Bruce Springsteen's from the same neck of the woods. How much is that your people and the influence of them?
We had a lot to do with it because we weren't in a major metropolis, so we could hone our craft in nightclubs when there was no media to pay attention to us or it. And it was at a much different time. I'm talking about, you know, the late 70s. So when we were in that place developing our craft, there was nothing. And you were close enough to New York City to see the light and to feel that, but far enough away that you could fall and figure it out. And we weren't in L.A., you know, so we were in a little suburban place called New Jersey.
I don't think that sort of doubt is much of an American thing.
Have a good
thing,
time
though.
Here, Frederick, because this is Robbie's show.
It's Robbie Williams' show.
I'm sorry. I won't get this chance very often. But, you know, doubt is not an American thing, really. I think that the thing that I've got, which is a load of doubt, might be a British thing.
I don't know that.
Right, okay.
I don't know that.
Do you have teenagers?
Yeah, my daughter is just shy of 20. She's our eldest. And then my eldest son is 18. And then another son who's 10 and another son who's 8.
How is it for a teenager to have John Bon Jovi as a father?
They don't run around listening to my records, no. I had to beg my daughter to listen to the new record, you know. It's like, what do you think? Because they're onto a whole different style of music now, you know. But they don't dislike it, and they're very aware of who their dad is, obviously. But it's just not a big deal in our house. It's not a big deal.
And you actually, you're going on tour. You're coming back to Europe on tour. It's called Because We Can. Is that why you do it?
It's just, see what obviously there you go. It's the American thing. Why? Because we can. It's the name of the first single. Really, just, it was that kind of thing where